Good morning students, in this video we are going to discuss about the next topic of network and cyber security called as transport layer security, cryptographic computations and HTTPS. Let's discuss about how actually the transport layer protocol or transport layer securities are going to be established with the help of a cryptographic computations and how HTTPS are going to be get used over there. What actually a transport layer security? A transport layer security is an IETF standardization initiative whose goal is to produce an internet standard version of SSL, secured socket layer. So the transport layer security is defined as a proposed internet standard in record format 5246, and 5246 record format is a very similar to that of SSL version 3. Secured socket layer version 3. Okay, this is a major difference which we can highlight in this particular video. What actually the TSL and SSL are going to be get vary over there. Let's be discuss about one by one over here. Okay, so the same record format as an SSL record format which have been used in the transport layer security as it has been defined in record format 5246 as well as record format 2246, and almost TLS and SSL version 3 are similar, but only a very few differences are going to be that we are going to discuss in this video. The first difference is nothing but version number. So this TSL record format is same as that of the SSL format record, and the field in this header have the same meaning, whereas the only difference is in this version value. For the current version of TSL, the major version is 3 and the minor version is 1, whereas in the SSL version 3 the minor version is going to be 0. That is the major difference which can come across over there with the SSL version 3 and TLS. So TLS consisting of a major version of 3 and a minor version of 1. That is the first difference. Second one, message authentication code. The message authentication code, if you're going to see, there are two differences between the SSL version 3 and TLS. One is nothing but MAC scheme. So the actual algorithm and the scope of the MAC calculation. And second one, the TLS makes use of HMAC algorithm which have been defined in record format 2104. So which can be it's nothing but HMAC of message is going to be taken as nothing but hash algorithm of key which is going to be get or XORed with the operand D, and which is going to be concatenated with the hash of key which is going to be given by the iPad, which is going to be concatenated with the message. That is the major difference which is going to be come across with the SSL version 3 and the TLS. And apart from this, if you're going to see about that pseudo random code, what do you mean by pseudo random code? Actually this TLS makes use of a pseudo random function which is going to be get referred to an PRF, which is going to be expand a secret into the block of data for the purpose of key generation or validation. The objective is to make use of relatively a small shared secret value, but not to generate a longer block of keys which is going to be get present over there, and longer keys as well as the data in a way that is secure from this kinds of attacks, which is going to be made on hash algorithm and max. So the PRF is based on the data expansion function which is going to be dealt as HMAC secret A1 concatenate seeds with secret 2 concatenate with secret 3 there, which is going to be present over there. So here the data expansion function makes use of an HMAC algorithm with either an MD5 or SHA1 as the underlying hash functions. As seen, the pHash can be iterated as many times as necessary to produce the required quantity of data. For example, PSA1, if you're going to use, it was used to generate a 64 byte of data. It would have to be iterated 4 times. producing an 80 bytes of data, of which the last 16 would be discarded. In this case, what happened, the PMD5 would also have to be iterated 4 times, producing exactly 64 bytes of data. So the each iteration involves 2 executions of HMAC, each of which in this turn involves 2 execution of the underlying hash algorithm. So that to make this PRF as secure as possible, it uses 2 hash algorithm in a way that should guarantee its security if either hash algorithm remains as secure. So that what happened, the PRF takes an input secret value and underlying the label and a seed value and producing an output of arbitrary length. There it's going to generate the pseudo random function. Next one, alert codes. In this alert code, if you're going to see, the TLS supports all of the alert codes which have been defined SSL version 3 with the exception of no certificate. So here the TLS does not support for the no certificate. Apart from that, it allows all the SSL version 3 certificates, and a number of additional codes are defined in the TLS of this, which we can see as record overflow, unknown CA, access denied, error, decode error, protocol version, insufficient security, unexpected extensions, internal error, decrypt error, user cancelled, no renegotiation. So these are the additional alerts which is going to be used in the TLS apart from SSL version 3. So such a way this SSL and TSL both are going to be differ in the alert codes. And coming to the next one, which is going to be called cipher suit. The cipher suit, there are several small differences between the cipher suit available under SSL version 3 and the TLS. So key exchange and the symmetric encryption algorithm, these are the two differences. In the key exchange, what happened, the TLS supports all of the exchange key exchange techniques of SSL 3 version 3 with the exception of FORTISA algorithm. And the symmetric encryption algorithm, TLS includes all of the symmetric encryption algorithm found in SSL version 3 with the exception of FORTISA. That is the main difference. So it won't allow the FORTISA algorithm for the key exchange or encryption algorithm. The next one is nothing but client certificate type. Here the client certificate type, what happened, TLS defines the following certificates, nothing but RSA sign, DSS sign, RSA fixed DH, DSS fixed DH. So these are the messages, certificate requests. These are the types of certificate which is going to be used over there in the TLS definition. And there are also which define in SSL 3. In addition to the SSL 3, which is going to use RSA Imperial DH, DSS Imperial DH, and FORTISA KEA. This Imperial Diffie-Hellman involves signing the Diffie-Hellman parameter with either RSA or DSS. For TSL, the RSS sign and DSS sign type are used for the function, as well as a separate signing type is not needed to sign Diffie-Hellman parameters. Therefore, TSL does not include the FORTISA scheme in this particular client certificate type. Next one, certificate verify and finish message. So here what happened, the TLS certificate verify message, the MD5 and SH1 hashes are calculated only over an handshake message. So recall that the SSL version 3, the hash calculations also included the master secret and the pads, whereas these extra fields were felt to add no additional security in this particular TLS. And with the finished message in SSL version 3, the finished message in TLS is a hash based on the shared master secret, the previous handshake message, and a label that identifies client or server. So the calculation is going to be somewhat differ for TSL as when compared with the SSL version 3. So the PRF data, where which is consisting of a finished label, is the string which is going to be having a client finished for the client and server finished for the server. That is going to be the major difference in the certificate verify and finish message in this particular TLS. Next one, cryptographic computation. Here, the master secret computation is going to be taken care in the TLS, which uses a different computation. What actually the different computation is going to use over there? We will see in the next slide. And coming to the last one, padding. What is padding? In the SSL, what happened? The padding added a prior encryption of user data in the minimum amount required. So that what happened? The total size of the data to be encrypted is a multiple of Cypress block length. In TLS, the padding can be any amount that results in a total that is a multiple of Cypress block length up to a maximum of 255 bytes. For example, if the plain text plus a MAC plus adding padding a data, the length byte may be a 75 byte long. Then the padding length can be 1 or 9 or 17 and so on up to 249. So a variable padding length may be used to frustrate the attack based on an analysis of the length of exchanged message. Such a way it can be used in this padding data in the TLS. This is the actual difference which is going to be get measured or which is going to be come across with the particular SSL when compared with the SSL version with the TLS version. So this is the major difference which is going to be get present and it's going to be get come across over there. Coming to the next two.